The difference between AMD's RX 6850M XT and Nvidia's RTX 3080 wasn't at all what I was expecting. I've compared both in 14 different games at 4K, 1440p, and 1080p resolutions to show you all the differences. These are the specs of both of these laptop GPUs. Stream processors and CUDA cores aren't directly comparable, but the 3080 has more memory with a larger memory bus and more bandwidth. The 3080 is also available with an 8GB option, but we've got the 16GB one here. So in this case, it's got more VRAM compared to the 12GB available to the 6850M XT. The power limits will vary depending on the specific laptop they're in, but the ones I've tested are max power. To do this testing, I'm using the ASUS ROG Z13 gaming tablet because it's the only device available that lets us use either of these GPUs. I could have attempted to use two different gaming laptops, but then we'd be introducing other differences like processor, cooling, memory, and more. It just seemed more fair to me to have both GPUs connected to the same machine. This way, we've got the same Intel i9-12900H CPU covered by the vapor chamber cooler and 16 gigs of LPDDR5 memory. The only difference is the GPU that we're connecting. The graphics that we're attaching are the XG Mobile from ASUS. Basically, these boxes have laptop graphics chips inside. But unlike traditional eGPUs that rely on Thunderbolt, these use a direct PCIe Gen 3 connection with 8 lanes, so they're much faster compared to Thunderbolt. Now, the 6850M XT is currently the best mobile graphics available from AMD, while Nvidia does now have the RTX 3080 Ti, but unfortunately ASUS aren't using that in an XG Mobile setup just yet, so the 3080 is as good as it gets. It would have been cool to compare the best options from both Nvidia and AMD, but as I've already shown in other videos, the difference between the 3080 and the 3080 Ti seems pretty small on the laptop side anyway. Alright, let's get into the 14 games tested at 3 different resolutions to show you all of the differences. Let's start out with Cyberpunk 2077. Down the bottom, we've got 1080p results run off the Z13 screen, and then 1080p results with an external screen connected to the XG Mobile just above. I've tested both because, in theory, sending the display signal back from the GPU to the tablet's display adds overhead. And sure enough, the external screen gives us a couple of extra frames. Otherwise, we've got 1440p on an external screen and 4K just above. The average FPS was quite similar between the two GPUs. However, Nvidia's 3080 had a clear lead in the 1% lows, so fewer dips in performance. Call of Duty Warzone is a game that I've found to usually perform better on AMD graphics, and this was certainly the case at 1080p and 1440p resolutions. Though given these high frame rates at max settings, it's not like the 3080 is unplayable or anything. The 3080 has a big comeback at 4K though, with a 30% higher average frame rate. It almost looks like a mistake, but I've seen that Nvidia generally does much better than AMD at 4K from my desktop GPU comparisons. Control, on the other hand, is a game that typically does better on Nvidia hardware. The 3080 was reaching a 13% higher average frame rate at the lower 1080p resolution, 29% higher at 1440p, but then a lower 17% lead at 4K. Granted, the 1% low from the 3080 was near the 6850M XT's average FPS. Not to mention, this game has DLSS support, which could be used to further boost 3080 performance. I've also tested this game with ray tracing enabled, and the performance gaps get even larger. I've shown in a number of other videos that Nvidia generally has the lead when it comes to ray tracing, and now regardless of the resolution, the 3080's 1% lows are higher than even the 6850M XT's averages at all resolutions. God of War had fairly average differences at the lower 1080p and 1440p resolutions, with the RTX 3080 9% and 19% ahead respectively. But then at 4K, it has the biggest lead out of all 14 games and 3 resolutions tested, with a 46% higher average frame rate. The 3080 was still nearly giving us 60fps at 4K high settings, while AMD was far behind. This game does have both FSR and DLSS though. With FSR set to quality mode, both GPUs are able to achieve some nice gains. They're quite close together at 4K now. Yeah, Nvidia still had the lead, but the gap is much smaller now. So a bigger gain for the 6850M XT here. Microsoft Flight Simulator also had big gains with Nvidia. This game had the biggest performance gap at 1080p and 1440p resolutions out of all 14 titles tested. And for some reason, I couldn't even run it on the Z13 screen at 1080p with the 6850M XT. No matter what I did, it just gave me a white screen, but it still ran fine shine on the external screen. Fortnite generally favors NVIDIA graphics, and sure enough, the 3080 was offering some big improvements over Radeon here. This game has DLSS support, so we could optionally use that to further boost NVIDIA, but even without it, NVIDIA had a good lead. It's also worth noting that 1080p with the external screen was giving a boost compared to the same resolution running through the Z13 screen, though NVIDIA saw a bigger increase, possibly because of the higher frame rates. The gaps weren't quite as big in Dying Light 2, but the RTX 3080 was still ahead in this one regardless of resolution. Neither was a smooth experience at 4K high settings, but we could also use FSR or DLSS to boost this. Both were still able to surpass 60fps at 1440p though, with the 3080 just 6fps ahead. Far Cry 6 was reaching about the same average frame rate at 1080p, with a slight edge to the 6850M XT in terms of 1% lows, but this changes once we get to higher resolutions. The 3080 was reaching 16% higher average FPS at the higher 1440p resolution, and 17% higher at 4K. Forza Horizon 5 was actually ahead on the 6850M XT at 1440p, but then not at any of the other resolutions. Not really sure why. But the 1% low from the 3080 was still quite a bit higher than AMD. Metro Exodus Enhanced Edition was better on the 3080 at all three resolutions. The 1% lows were about the same with either GPU at 1080p, but in terms of average FPS, the 3080 was 25% ahead of the 6850M XT, and about the same lead at the higher 1440p and 4K resolutions too. Assassin's Creed Valhalla, on the other hand, was quite similar with either GPU at the lower 1080p resolution. At 1440p though, the 3080 has a 16% lead, and then a smaller 9% lead at 4K. This is a game I've found to favor AMD in the past, but despite this, the 6850M XT was still never ahead in any of these tests. Watch Dogs Legion had above average gains with the 3080 compared to the other games tested. I mean, you can see how big some of the gaps are here. The 1% lows from the 3080 are close to the average FPS of the 6850M XT at 1440p, and then ahead of it at 4K. The Witcher 3 is an older game, but still quite popular, and this one was a win for the 6850M XT at all resolutions. The 1% lows in particular at 1080p had quite a big improvement, but yeah, at ultra settings, 150fps with 120 for the 1% low is still going to play very well. Shadow of the Tomb Raider is another older one, but also a title where the 6850M XT was ahead at all three resolutions. On average, over all 14 games tested, at the lower 1080p resolution, the RTX 3080 was nearly 9% faster than the RX 6850M XT. The Radeon GPU was only clearly ahead in three titles, as shown at the bottom of the graph. Another three titles basically had no major difference, though technically they were slightly ahead with NVIDIA, while the rest of the games had clear gains with the 3080. Stepping up to the higher 1440p resolution, and on average, the RTX 3080 was now reaching 11% higher average FPS compared to the 6850M XT in the same selection of games. This wasn't too surprising, as comparisons with desktop graphics cards have already shown us that, generally speaking, NVIDIA's RTX 30 series does better at higher resolutions like 1440p, and especially 4K. This explains why the 3080 was now reaching an 18% higher average FPS on average out of these 14 games. Only two titles down the bottom were still able to do better on the 6850M XT, and they're both older games. Best case, we're seeing nearly a 50% boost with the 3080. Not only was the 3080 generally performing better, but it was doing this while consuming less power. This is the total amount of power drawn at the wall, so it includes both the XG Mobile eGPU as well as the Flow Z13 tablet, so it's Intel CPU and everything else as well. The Radeon GPU was using 37% more power, quite a big difference considering that even in the absolute best case, the 3080 was only 13% slower. I've also compared the total system latency, so the time between a mouse click and when a gunshot fires on the screen in CSGO. Regardless of whether we're going through the NVIDIA or Radeon GPU, the times are about the same, well within the margin of error range. It's not all just about gaming though. The 3080 was scoring 8% higher than the 6850M XT in Adobe Premiere. This wasn't too surprising, as I've always found NVIDIA GPUs to do better in this test. NVIDIA was still ahead in DaVinci Resolve, but they're much closer together now, with the 3080 only scoring about 2% higher than the Radeon option. I've also tested SpecView Perf, which tests out various professional 3D workloads.
workloads. The 3080 was ahead in most cases, but the 6850M XT was ahead in 3 of the 8 tests. So it just depends on the specific workload. The 3D Mark results don't really match up with what we saw in the games. In Firestrike and TimeSpy, the RX 6850M XT was ahead, though it had lower ray tracing performance compared to the 3080 in the Port Royal test, something we did actually see in a game earlier.
The gaming results are kind of strange. At 1080p, the RTX 3080 was about 9% higher than the 6850M XT. When I previously compared the 3080 against the 6800M, I found that they were basically equivalent on average at 1080p. So based on that, you'd expect the 6850M XT to easily beat the 3080, not be behind. So then why is the higher tier 6850M XT worse? How many more times am I going to say 6850M XT? It's quite a mouthful. Both are good questions that I can't really answer. Maybe ASUS needs a driver update to offer the full performance of the 6850M XT or something. It is still relatively new. I was expecting this comparison to be more fair, as both GPUs are tested on the exact same hardware. So same CPU with the same cooling and same RAM. The only difference is the graphics. I thought it might be possible that there's some weird graphics conflict going, because if you think about how the Z13 works, in order to use the Radeon graphics, we need 3 different graphics drivers installed. First, we need the Intel graphics for the Intel integrated CPU, then we need Nvidia graphics because mine has the RTX 3050 Ti inside, and if we were just using the RTX 3080, we could stop there, but because I'm using the RX 6850M XT, we need the Radeon graphics drivers too. So Intel, Nvidia, and AMD graphics drivers all on one device. What could go wrong? Now, I did actually try removing the Nvidia graphics entirely with DDU, but I didn't find that to make a difference in my retesting. The 6850M XT was performing the same regardless. I've also got to say that the RTX 3080 just worked better. One of the major issues I had with the 6850M XT was I couldn't even load up Red Dead Redemption 2. The game just didn't open at all, and I even did a reset of Windows and freshly downloaded the game files, and same thing even with a clean OS. That was the only game out of 15 that had a show-stopping problem. I guess I did also have the issue with Flight Simulator loading at 1080p on the Z13 screen with the AMD graphics. That was a bit weird, but it still did at least run on the external screen. But yeah, all things considered, I did find the RTX 3080 more stable, I guess you could say. Now, I'd love to compare pricing, but right now the XG Mobile is extremely difficult to actually find anywhere to buy. It seems like in most cases it comes bundled with a Z13 or an X13. In any case, I can definitely say that they're not cheap. I'll leave some links in the description below that you can check out in the off chance that they do become available. Maybe I need to revisit this comparison with 2 different laptops with these GPUs, just in case whatever's going on here is something specific to the XG Mobile. If you are looking at an XG Mobile specifically for a setup like this, personally, I'd be going for the RTX 3080, though it does of course depend on the price difference. But yeah, generally speaking, the 3080 was both performing better in most games, it offers superior ray tracing performance, and you get DLSS. Both can of course use FSR, but the fact is, many games only have DLSS. So in those cases, the 3080 can make use of that. Otherwise, there are some small differences between these two units, like the 6850M XT has 2.5 gigabit Ethernet and HDMI 2.1, while the older 3080 unit only has gigabit Ethernet and HDMI 2.0b. Check out how the 6800M compares against the RTX 3080 in this video next. Once you've seen those results, you'll understand why I'm so confused about what I've shown in this video. And of course, make sure you're subscribed to the channel for future laptop comparisons like this one.